right, I'm just gonna make a quick little video on how to combine your solar panels using a combiner box, all right? So, depending on the type of solar panel you have, you got two wires coming out of here. These are Zamp 170 watt made in the USA panels, all right? Now these ones come with a heat shrink and a female to put in your cable. I am using the standard recommended cable here, which I believe is a, here we go, it's stamped on the side. This is a 10 gauge, two wire, and this is, you know, this is what you get at AM Solar when you order products and you're looking for wire for your solar panels. Now, this right here is what is combined, combiner box. There is a hole through the roof where those large wires are. That goes down to your directly to your charge controller, okay? This is a much thicker wire. I believe it is a 4 or a 6. I think it's a 6 gauge. That goes in this particular combiner box, to the middle. There's a lug right there, and you just screw that down pretty tight so this doesn't come out. Wrap the wires around, or heat shrink it if you want to get fancy with it, or if your kit comes with it, and make sure that's secure. And then every single one of these little other screw holes is for a solar panel to go. So, this is really easy. Even I can do it. I'm not a pro, all right? So this wire comes off of the solar panel, then you crimp it. I recommend using a good crimper, heavy-duty crimper like this, all right? Not the little cheap, chintzy electrical ones. It's just a little bit too hard, in my opinion, okay? So what you do is you connect this end of it. You gotta cut it with a razor blade, just like I did here. Then you gotta strip this off, all right? And then what you do, you give it a good old-fashioned crimp, heat shrink it. Now the other end, you slide it in here into one of these holes. Now, what you gotta do is, I don't know the name of these things, but you put in the thread this way, and then you tighten it down here, okay? Sometimes you have to slide the wire in before you put this in the combiner box. Once it's in, you twist this around here and you tighten it. It locks against the plastic, this particular thread. This one doesn't lock against the plastic. Plastic on plastic. Make sure it is hand tight. And make sure you have, well, somewhere around 6 to 8 inches coming out of here. So then you can put it into these bars on either side here. Okay? Now you will notice it says solar negative and solar positive. Okay? Match up the positive to positive, red to red, and then here you go red to red. So all I would do to complete this job is to strip the wire down, put it inside one of these holes, and then tighten down the screw. Once all the solar panels are connected, you will put on the box to the combiner box with some screws all the way. Now what I will do to finish up this job is to put dicor around the side. All right, I use butyl tape around the whole opening, and I will also reinforce it with some kind of waterproof dicor, self-leveling sealant, or some kind of silicone that doesn't deteriorate from the sunlight, all right? So, in a nutshell, that is how you install a combiner box. Now, when you have all these wires with the solar panel, you're going to want to keep them nice and snug so they don't rattle around when you're driving. AM Solar provides a roof wire harness accessory kit, which includes a 3M adhesive backed, what would you even call this? Some kind of sticky thing, right? So then what you do is you take a zip tie and you push it through the sides, and then you secure the wire to the underside of the solar panel. You could also do it to the side of the mounts. I don't recommend doing it to the roof, unless you got some serious construction adhesive or something else. This particular 3M adhesive I wouldn't recommend on this roof. I used a elastomeric roof, and it's very hard to adhere things to. So anyways, again, very simple job. This is a beginner type thing. Do not cross positive and negatives. As you can see here with the solar panels, we are covering them. A couple of them came off because it was windy. But if you do this in the daytime, cover your panels. Otherwise you're gonna blow a fuse or damage the panels. I just wanna say thanks to Zamp for providing the panels, and thanks to AM Solar for providing the combiner box. I do have a discount, that is good. Until 2019, there also I can update a special link in this video. I need to talk to the guys over AM Solar for a 5 to 10% discount on pretty much everything they sell. So through that link or the discount code JAX5 or JAX10 or any combination of the two, you should get some kind of discount. If it's not working, call the guys, tell them you watched a video here on my channel. They will give you a discount. Thanks for watching. We'll see you in the next upload.